Hi guys, Nesty here. The new patch hit today and Tanya arrived. So let's just take a look. I think the Tanyas are really interesting, at least two of them. Let's first start with the fire one. There is no water and wood version of her. You can only catch the fire version and fuse light and dark. So let's start with the fire one. Stat-wise, she's an average net 3 monster in my opinion. Skill-wise, she's really good. Really, really, really good in my opinion. Because I think she will make some content even available. Let's say GB9, for example, the wood golem. Normally everyone is farming GB8 because with the water monas and that stuff, you can really clear it fast. If you have siphon sets, the golem itself don't have that much HP, so even that one will fall very fast, so you will reach really fast times. But this Fire Tanya is the first monster with such a strong active skill. Obviously, it's a predator against wood, but we want to use it against wood, so yeah, it's more of a niche monster, but I think in that niche, she really shines. I think this monster can make GB9 available with a similar time to GB8. Because let's say you use two or three of her, two with a siphon set, and she will not even, well, not only clear the waves really fast, but she will destroy the Titan, the Golem. So yeah, I will test that. I will most likely go for two or three of her while trying to give them siphon sets. Keep in mind that she's not that good against Titans. Firebeth still deals a lot more damage than the Tanya because her active is an AoE with a 1.1 multiplier, and Firebeth has the single target predator with a 2.3 multiplier. So against Titans, Beth is still a lot stronger, but yeah, that's not her content. She's more of a wave clearer in my opinion. Because she has this really, really strong AoE. She's the only monster with such a strong AoE in my opinion. I don't know. Yeah. The only monster with such a strong AoE against one element. Every other monster with such a high damage multiplier, like the Wood Predator one, is always single target. So yeah. This is the first monster of that, and she even comes with a really good leader skill. So I think she will make GB9 really available, so you can reach a similar time to GB8. Or if you're a newer player, obviously she can make that content available for you. Let's go to the light one. Stat-wise, she's, I think, an average net 4. Not as OP as the Kiki. She has easily net 5 stats. Tanya has average net 4 stats, in my opinion, but that's not bad. She has good HP, good attack, and acceptable defense. So, stat-wise, she's totally fine. There are a lot of worst mons. She has the new skill Merciless Strike. I think this is a niche skill as well, because she really shines if you have a lot of debuffs onto your opponent. Every debuff on the opponent will increase her damage by 20%, with a maximum of 200%, or like 10 debuffs. So the first content that comes in mind for me is GB10. But I think she's limited there. Because she's a light monster, this is good on the one hand, but bad on the other hand. Because obviously, if you use her, you need other light monsters. Otherwise, the dark monsters will focus her down. So, if you have a team like a lot of people have Toadora lead and three raiders, or at least two raiders and something else, I think she can be the new Toadora, let's say the new Toadora, because she has the same leader skill. So you can use her as lead plus three Zappa. Because, yeah, I think the Merciless Strike with three Zappa, let's say an average five zaps onto the golem, which means she will have a 100% increased damage. I think this could outdamage a Zappa. Needs some more testing. If they are available and I have the light one, I will test it. If the damage is really good or if just another Zappa is still stronger. So yeah, we just have to wait until she will come out, so we can use the Merciless Strike. If, let's say, an average of 5 zaps with a 100% increased damage is enough to outdamage another Zappa or not. Yeah, don't use her if you don't have other light monsters, because then she will get focused down. And obviously, who knows, maybe she's even available in a different content. In Arena, I think she's not good, obviously, because your opponents have a lot of resistance. So it's not that easy to land any debuffs. You don't want to bring Zappa into Arena, because, yeah, obviously that is not a strong skill in Arena. So the content that really comes into my mind for her is GB10 with a light team. But, yeah, we have to test that. The dark one. Normally we don't have to talk about her stats and skills and whatever. You see she has a taunt and a silence that already makes her useless. She's like the Water Shiva of the Darknet Force, so she's completely useless. Yeah. No idea why they made such a monster. I don't see any reason behind this. But at least that makes it easier for you to decide to what the monster you should go for. That obviously is the light one. But I think the fire one is even better. So you should go for the fire one, in my opinion, first. And then go for the light one, if you don't have that Raiders team. Yeah, I will show you both into a different video if they are available. I personally think that the fire one is really good and will deal a lot of damage, and the light one might be good depending on the damage itself, if it's really enough to outdamage a fourth Zappa or not. When they're out, we will do a new video and I will show you the testing. So that's it for the preview. See you soon, guys. Ciao.